voiceovers are hard, and I've done way too many now that I just don't know what I'm doing with myself. Hey, it's Tess. Today I'm mimicking my Hakugan sign onto my brother's sewing machine. I've had it for about 8 years now, and it's really been my trusted sewing machine because it did fall off the table and got damaged. I'm surprised it lasted, and it really does deserve a nice facelift. So right now I'm adding in some washi tape to protect the stitching panel because I don't want to damage that. There's 60 stitches on there. It would not go well if I tried drawing those later. I take off the factory inspection sticker, and our brand of choice today is Crayola. JK, it's just Posca markers. I just store my Posca markers into a Crayola zipper pouch, which may or may not be the best misleading clickbait. Because the brand comparison, I don't think Crayola has paint markers to make that really an issue, but if they did, it would be a nice comparison to see how well they do on diverse material. But right now, I'm just using Posca markers. I know that they can be used on different textured materials, whether it is paper, rocks, or fabric. I'm using it on hard plastic that has a slick texture. I should probably sand this, but I'm not doing that. I don't want to ruin the shell of my sewing machine that much besides adding a little bit of acrylic paint to it. So right now I'm adding in a base coat of aqua blue onto the shell of my sewing machine. I decided against doing the whole machine because if I was to add fabric, it would end up rubbing on the sewing machine and would cause a bit of friction. It could end up messing up. Who knows? I don't want to play around with that. I could add a sealant to protect it from doing that, but I don't know if adding a sealant would end up causing any issues when it comes to the fabric friction. So I'm just leaving it to the front facing panel. I'm sure there's other ways to go about this, but I'm not sure. I'm trying to clean up my line so I don't end up screwing it up with Lysol wipes, which in our current times is probably a hard thing to come by. Adding different colors at various areas, it's gonna be a lot of chicken scratch moment. I don't really have a method for how I'm laying color besides blending it all together and eventually making it look okay for myself. Because really the only person I'm trying to please is myself, because it is part of my supplies. I did accidentally use a basic blue, but decided to go against it because it just wasn't hitting the same hues as the other colors, and adding in midnight blue, which right now it's gonna look too different than the rest of the machine. I'm going to add in the blue that's from the actual brother's panel itself. It takes a little bit of that tone, but it's not an exact blue. It does help it blend a little bit more. And right now we're just adding in more color, because that's what we do. And it's going to be a bit. I do kind of like the abstract part of this. There's probably better ways to go about it. It's a little bit hard to really paint on the sewing machine because with it being slick, it kind of stays on the hard shell itself and becomes a little bit puddled up, as you'll eventually notice when I have to wait to actually continue. Some areas of improvement on here is how I should have done with the cleanup, because on some of the buttons you'll end up having a line of paint. In practicality, I didn't really want to paint on them, but as you can see, I'm trying to clean it up and then I just keep on messing with it, so I end up coloring the whole thing. It just seemed like the best approach. It does tie it in a little bit better, but it does not leave me satisfied that that is the only area that has the dark blue. I'm not sure the best route for the speed module or this changing the stitch. I would rather them be consistent, but with those buttons being more used, I didn't want to end up putting paint on them. Eventually take yellow to go in and add more in green tones because I can blend it in a little bit more to give it a little bit my variety of the color spectrum that I'm using, since I am using a lot of cool tones. I don't add purple into this, even though you can clearly tell there's purple on the side. Not sure why. I didn't use purple in the hot glue gun, so that's probably why I chose not to. As you can see, I cleaned it up, but now I'm looking at the wet paint to analyze at what point I have to go in and add the stars, because they have to be dry. But I do mess up on the stars, as you can clearly tell. I end up using that mess up to add paint to make other stars, and eventually dab it away, but it's still kind of closely there. Cleaning up and refining with more stars, and then I'm gonna go in and touch up the speedometer area with some metallic, and then cleaning up the other buttons, and then cleaning up the front face because it got a little bit messy because paint decided to leak. And then I'm taking out the washi tape and soon realizing that it was not clean. So I panicked and tried to clean it and then messed it up more by doing that. I also did try taking a Posca marker and cleaning it up, but that messed up. So here we are with my maker, and I measured out the stitch panel to add in a rectangle vinyl. This is removable vinyl. I probably should have used premium vinyl. I don't have premium vinyl at the moment, so this is what I got. So I removed a small bit of the transfer tape to cover that section. This is a different way to take off the vinyl itself, just because it's a small rectangle and I didn't want to waste the full amount of vinyl that was contained. As you can see, it makes it bubbly. I will fix that later so I can reuse it. But right now I am applying that vinyl back onto the stitch panel. As you can see, I did add the factory inspection sticker back on where it does belong. And now it's all together. And I do really like how this turned out. I am interested to see how long this will last on my sewing machine. It gives a little bit of tender love, and that's what I like. And here's it alongside the hot glue gun. They look more like a family. And yeah, subscribe if you want. I'm not sure how often I will be making videos.